Hey there, Bridge family, it's Pastor Jeff, and today I'd like to offer you a cautionary note that comes from Acts chapter 14, verse 2. We're told in Acts 14, verse 2, that as Paul and Barnabas were going, sent by God to share the truth and love of God's word, that the religious leaders were causing the people to be stirred up in resistance to God's people, God's word, God's will, and God's ways. And the scripture says that those bad religious leaders literally poisoned the minds of those listeners and turned them away from God's men, turned them away from God's messengers, turned them away from God's word, will, and way. And I just want to caution you, per the sermon on Sunday, if you look at the sad and tragic example of the Jonestown Massacre, 918 souls followed Jim Jones and drank his poison, literally drank his poison. It was Kool-Aid. Friend, I want to encourage you to think long and hard about who you're listening to. Look deep into their lives. Don't trust their resumes. Don't trust their personalities. Look at the witness of their walk. Look at the witness of their work, of their warfare, and recognize that there are those who are poisoning the minds of others that God would be speaking to if they hadn't been stirred up against the truth by those who were intentionally poisoning the minds of the listeners. And recognize that, like Jim Jones, there can be those who look on the outside as though they're winsome and trustworthy and humble, when in reality they were the devil's workers. Remember, the devil is in the division, and it's the devil who makes the Kool-Aid that poisons the people. It's the devil and his workers who make poison Kool-Aid. Acts chapter 14, verse 2 gives it to us biblically, missionally. I pray it comes to you personally. Watch out for the Jim Joneses and their poison Kool-Aids. Trust the word of God, the word of God and the workers of God, and go deep into your evaluations. Just think about how many people God was speaking to through Paul and Barnabas that the religious leaders poisoned into not hearing and thus not believing. This is real war. The suffering is intense, and the stakes could not be higher. We're talking about the glory of God and the eternal resting place for torment of souls. Amen and amen.